Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 25th of December. Indian Prime Minister Modi defends farm laws, offers talks based on facts and logic. Taliban presence in Pakistan will challenge peace, says Afghanistan. And Christians in India celebrate Christmas amid coronavirus pandemic. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Friday said his government is ready to talk to even those opposing new farm laws, but the discussion should be based on facts. The Prime Minister made the remarks at a virtual event while interacting with farmers of six states, during which he also released over $2.4 billion to 90 million farmers, the latest tranche of funds under a government scheme.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Friday, while interacting with farmers of six states, said the government is ready to talk to those opposing new farm laws, but the discussion should be based on facts. The Prime Minister made the remarks at a virtual event during which he released over 18,000 crore rupees, that is over $2.4 billion, to more than 90 million farmers, the latest tranche of funds under a government scheme. Taking jibe at the opposition parties amid farmers' protests across India, PM Modi said some parties are pushing political agenda by opposing new farm laws and are spreading myth and lies against the government.
Hamari sarkar kisan hit mein unse bhi baat karne ke liye tayar hai, lekin baat muddon par hogi.
Meanwhile, farmers intensified their ongoing agitation at Delhi borders on Friday against the three farm laws that liberalized agriculture sector. There were also reports of clashes as protesting farmers ran tractors over police barricading placed to stop them from entering the capital. Government maintains farmers' demand for repeal of the three farm laws is non-negotiable. Thousands of farmers from several Indian states have been camped on the outskirts of New Delhi for over a month, blocking highways to demand government repeal the farm laws passed in September, as they fear the laws will threaten their livelihoods.
India on Friday paid tributes to former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee on his 96th birth anniversary. India's President Ramnath Kovind and Prime Minister Narendra Modi, along with other leaders, paid floral tributes to Vajpayee at his memorial in Indian capital New Delhi. Later in the day, PM Modi also released a book titled Atal Bihari Vajpayee in the Parliament, a commemorative volume on the former Prime Minister on his birth anniversary, which is celebrated as Good Governance Day. Born on 25th of December 1924, Vajpayee was the first leader of India's ruling Bharatiya Janata Party to be sworn in as Prime Minister. Vajpayee was the moderate face of Hindu nationalism and was admired by his political foes. He is also known for ordering nuclear tests in 1998 during his second term in a strategic masterstroke to blunt Pakistan's nuclear ambitions. In news from Afghanistan. As a wave of assassinations ravages the violence-hit country, Afghan women's rights activist Freshta Kohistani was shot dead along with her brother by unknown gunmen in Kapisa province on Thursday. Days before her death, Kohistani, who is survived by her husband and one child, wrote on Facebook that she had asked for protection from the authorities after receiving threats. 29-year-old Kohistani is the second activist to be killed in 2 days after a prominent pro-democracy advocate was gunned down in capital Kabul on Wednesday. On Tuesday, five doctors were also killed in a targeted attack. On Monday night, Rahmatullah Nikzad, a freelance reporter and head of a media safety union in Ghazni, was killed in an attack by unknown armed men in the province. Journalists, politicians and rights activists have increasingly been targeted as violence surges in Afghanistan, despite peace talks between the government and the Taliban. More on news from Afghanistan. Afghanistan's foreign ministry has said the presence of the Taliban leaders and their fighters in Pakistan is a clear violation of Afghanistan's national sovereignty. The ministry made the remarks after a video of Taliban leader Abdul Ghani Baradar went viral, where he was addressing some members of the group in Pakistan's Karachi this week.
The presence of the Taliban leaders and their fighters in Pakistan is a clear violation of Afghanistan's national sovereignty, the Afghan Foreign Ministry said on Friday, reacting to a recent video of Taliban deputy leader Abdul Ghani Baradar, who addressed some members of the group in Karachi this week. The ministry in a statement said the presence of the Taliban leaders and their members will continue the ongoing crisis and instability in the region, and it will challenge the efforts to ensure lasting peace in Afghanistan. The ministry called on Pakistan to prevent insurgents from using its territory against Afghanistan. This comes as Taliban's negotiating team, including Abdul Ghani Baradar, visited Pakistan last week, shortly after they paused the peace talks in Doha for 23 days. Pakistan then said the visit of Taliban delegation was part of Pakistan's policy to reach out to key Afghan parties in the Afghan peace process, with a view to facilitating the intra-Afghan negotiations.
The United States has expressed deep concerns over Pakistan's Sindh High Court ruling on Thursday to release multiple terrorists responsible for the murder of American journalist Daniel Pearl. In 2002, Pearl, a 38-year-old journalist of the Wall Street Journal, was abducted and beheaded while he was in Pakistan investigating a story of terror groups' links to Al-Qaeda.
The U.S. State Department said it is deeply concerned at the reports of a Pakistani court ordering the release of terrorists involved in the murder of U.S. journalist Daniel Pearl. The terrorists are set to be released on Saturday. In a series of tweets, the State Department said, "We are deeply concerned by the reports of the December 24 ruling of Sindh High Court to release multiple terrorists responsible for the murder of Daniel Pearl. We have been assured that the accused have not been released at this time." The Sindh High Court on Thursday ordered the release of Al-Qaeda leader Ahmed Omar Saeed Sheikh and his three aides, Fahad Naseem, Salman Saqib and Sheikh Adil, after the court said the Daniel Pearl case charges against them are null and void. Daniel Pearl, the 38-year-old South Asia bureau chief for the Wall Street Journal, was abducted and beheaded while he was in Pakistan investigating a story in 2002 on the links between the country's powerful spy agency ISI and Al-Qaeda.
Moving on, several friends and fellow activists of renowned Baloch activist Karima Baloch staged a demonstration outside Canada's Toronto police headquarters to demand thorough investigation into her mysterious death in the city earlier this week. The protesters alleged role of state actors into her death, as she frequently got threats for exposing atrocities by the Pakistani state and the army in Balochistan.
Several friends and fellow activists on Thursday staged a protest outside Canada's Toronto police headquarters, demanding thorough investigation into the mysterious death of Baloch activist Karima Baloch in the city earlier this week. The protesters rejected Toronto police findings of no foul play into Karima's death. Karima Baloch's dead body was found drowning in Lake Ontario, Harbourfront, Toronto, on Monday, after she went missing on Sunday afternoon. The protesters alleged role of state actors and termed the death of the 37-year-old activist as murder, as she frequently got death threats for exposing atrocities by the Pakistani state and the army in Balochistan.
Aur hamari guzarish hai Canadian sarkar se ki wo aage aake ek deep investigation kare aur agar iske piche koi taakte hain unko samne laaye aur unhe saza de.
Karima Baloch was known for raising the issue of ongoing human rights violation in Balochistan and blamed Pakistan of exploiting natural resources and eliminating the dissenting voices in the region at international forums, including the UN.
Moving on to news from Nepal. The Supreme Court of Nepal on Friday issued a show cause order to the Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli led government for dissolving the parliament, a move that has plunged the Himalayan nation into political turmoil.
Nepal's Supreme Court on Friday issued a show cause order to the Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli led government for the sudden dissolution of the parliament and call for fresh elections, a move denounced by his opponents as unconstitutional. The apex court's constitutional bench, hearing writ petitions against the move, ordered the government to provide the original document of the decision made by the Council of Ministers and Office of the President regarding the same. Oli this week said he decided to dissolve the parliament on December 20 after facing non-cooperation from senior leaders of his ruling Nepal Communist Party, and a fresh mandate was the only way to settle disputes. The decision has triggered unrest in his party and protests on the streets of the capital, Kathmandu. Seven ministers have stepped down to challenge the dissolution and stated that it was a violation of the popular mandate given to them in 2017 general election. PM Oli was scheduled to hold a cabinet meeting later on Friday evening. Sources said he was planning to reshuffle the cabinet.
Christians across India on Friday celebrated Christmas with fervor and devotion while keeping in mind precautionary measures amid the coronavirus pandemic. The celebrations began after midnight mass in churches marking the birth of Jesus Christ.
Members of Christian community in India celebrated Christmas across the country while keeping in mind the coronavirus protocols amid the pandemic on Friday. Devotees in capital New Delhi and southern Thiruvananthapuram city started the celebrations with offering prayers after midnight mass in churches marking the birth of Jesus Christ. Every year, Christmas in India is celebrated with much pomp and show, but this time due to the pandemic, the celebrations were a low-key affair to prevent the spread of the virus.
We are having only a symbolic celebration this year. Only selected representatives are invited to be part of the Holy Eucharist, which is the main prayer that we have as Christians, as Catholics, and we have restricted the number of entry to the church today.
COVID has taught us the true sense of Christmas to be simple, with less celebration, care for the others, concern for the others. I think Pope has also conveyed this to all the Christians all over the world to have care for the others this time.
Christians form less than 3% of India's more than 1 billion population, but Christmas is now widely celebrated in metros and other big cities with fervor and devotion.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. Indian Prime Minister Modi defends farm laws, offers talks based on facts and logic. Taliban presence in Pakistan will challenge peace, says Afghanistan. And Christians in India celebrate Christmas amid coronavirus pandemic. Now, our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at SAsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.